Hey guys, it's Julian from 365MUSCLEUK, and this is going to be the first part of my road to the British Championships, which is actually going to be held in Birmingham at the BodyPower Expo. So the plan for this series is pretty much to go over my training as I prepare for the competition, which as I said is the British Championships, so Nationals. And yeah, it'll just follow me as I get ready, as I try to make weight, and hopefully we'll see how I get on at the competition. Hopefully I'm going to hit some PBs. So in this leg session, I was pretty much wanting to see and feel where I was at, because I hadn't done any like real heavy squats since I injured my hamstring a while ago. So I've still been deadlifting heavy, and I had still been training legs, but I just wanted to have like a feeler. So I thought I'd go up to a reasonably heavy weight. So this is one of my last warm-up sets. I believe this was 220. Yeah, and it moved pretty well. It felt all right. And I just hadn't been used to wearing my knee wraps either. So that was something else. I just wanted to remember how it felt like, because that can play a part in your mind. And then, yep, I moved on from 220. I made the jump to 250, which is pretty normal. And yeah, I thought it moved pretty well. I was quite pleased with this session. And then after this session, I went on with the full leg session, so all of my accessory work and more reps on the squats. So now we move on to my shoulder session. I'm not sure why, but for some weird reason I just didn't record my my chest session, so I haven't got any bench press from this week. No idea why, but this is week one pretty much, so quite lightweight on my shoulder press. It's just warming up. I do pin press from a seat. It just allows me to rest my lower back. There's no risk of being in a bad position and straining my lower back, which would then hinder me when I come back to train deadlift and squats. I'd rather just take that risk away. And I find pin press, which is what I'm doing now, seems to carry over quite well to my bench press, especially with quite a slightly narrower grip, which you can see here. So yeah, this is just my working set. I think it was 91 kg. A couple of reps, a few sets. Yeah, so this is a good start point for my prep. And then we see I move on to a few more accessories. I mean, I'm not gonna film and show absolutely everything and all of my training. It just might get a bit boring. But let me know in the comments if you want to see a particular part of my training, or if you find some parts of it boring, and I'll just cut it out, or maybe I'll add it in. Let me know down below. So I often do quite a light cable lateral raise in front and for range of motion, and then I also do this behind the back with a very short range of motion just to keep constant tension. And I'll usually do this for up to 12 reps. I usually do it as a warm-up, and sometimes I'll also do it as a finisher at the end of my shoulder session. So here we have my first week of deadlifts for this prep. I was doing deficit pause deadlift, if I remember correctly. So yeah, I am. So I use a plate for my deficit, and I'll pause, as I've done in my previous videos, mid shin, and it'll explode up. And anytime I was doing pause deficit deadlifts this entire prep, I've decided I wanted to try and do it without my belt, just to try and improve my technique, and hopefully to make me a little bit stronger, because I find that the carryover from pause deadlift and deficit deadlift really helps, and it usually carries over pretty well to my regular deadlift. Move on to my next leg session, and as you can see, the weight's obviously lighter. The reason being is because as a prep, as anyone who's prepped for any competition knows, you have to peak. So the weight will generally start off reasonably light and progressively get heavier as your prep continues. So the closer you get to your competition, the heavier and more intense your training will usually become. It's very rare that you can really go like 100% week in, week out, trying to hit PBs week in, week out, and then come into a competition and hit a PB. I don't really know anyone who can do that, but it might be possible, but I personally don't do that. So at this stage, the weight was a lot lighter. The reps were a bit higher. People still walking in front of my camera, it's cool. Also you'll notice that I've changed from my flats and squats to heels. And so far, so good. I actually really, really enjoy it. We'll see how it goes at competition. It'll be the first time I've ever used them at competition. Fingers crossed, I'm really looking forward to trying them out. And you can see here, I'm doing some front squats with a very slow negative. And then I believe I was supersetting them with RDLs, which is why I have the bar just behind me. I'm doing these accessories beltless, and I'm just working on controlling my breathing, making sure my technique is improving. And slowly as the prep goes on, I'll plan on adding weight and progressing that way. So yeah, we'll see how this goes. Okay, so finally I remembered to film one of my chest sessions, and this clip I was actually overloading, so it's towards the end of my flat press in this training session, and this is at one of my other gyms because I train at a few different gyms. This one's actually pretty hard to film at because there's just so many people and the gym's pretty small. Yeah, you can see people still walk in front. I put on my slingshot and I think it was 195. I wanted to go for a triple just to see how it felt. When I prep, I like to use my slingshot, and I'll vary between that and pin press just to overload. Now we move on to my next session in deadlift. And for this session, I was doing a few sets of heavy doubles. I was doing 252. The bar was moving reasonably well, especially at this point in prep. I seem to find that the start of prep for me is quite hard, so the weight will feel pretty heavy and it might not move as quickly as I'm used to, and then around the middle of prep, hopefully it should move a lot quicker, and then they'll get a phase where I think my body will just start to get a bit tired and need that deload, which is very close to the end of prep, and then after the deload I should be performing peak performance as I go into a competition. But yeah, as we're coming to the end of this video pretty much, the plan for the rest of the parts of this prep is to basically talk about my training how I found prep. I'm gonna hopefully do a competition day video as well, so I'll do exactly how I get on, and yeah, we'll see how we get on. I'm looking forward to this competition. Normally I just do international competitions, but BodyPower should be really exciting. Loads of my friends are going to be there, and there should be a really good crowd. So watch this space. I done fucked a million girls them with a little ting-a-ling-a-ling. School bell a ring, hit her with my ding-a-ling-a-ling. Maybe run a train, tell her that my niggas wanna bang in a little brain, and she wanna hang with the gang with a nigga name. Shabba, shabba ranks, shabba ranks. 8 gold rings like I'm shabba ranks.